What's up, guys? This is Manoj Uptani. I welcome you all on behalf of the ADPDO world. It's been a fantastic morning outside, and I'm sure that you guys must be enjoying your life to the fullest, guys. Certainly, you are. So, how's your preparation going on with the remaining subjects? How's your preparation going on with SFM? Is it going good? Wonderful, guys. So, this is going to be the seventh video presentation in which I'm going to discuss with you the remaining questions which have already been asked with respect to the topic of derivatives. This is going to be the final video of this particular chapter. By now, I am hoping that certainly you guys have revised your topics completely, and surely you're thorough with the concepts, whatever the kind of things that Institute expects out of you guys. I have made you understand each one of that particular thing. So I just hope that you are retaining your topics time and again, because that is something which is extremely imperative for each one of you. Don't skip on that, guys. Remember it. So let's mark the beginning of this particular presentation, which is going to be the final conclusion of derivatives. And I hope you guys are going to be liking it like anything. So let's move towards the last question of this particular topic, which was asked in CE final examination multiple times, November 2008, May 2010, and November 2011. It says an investor has the following position on the options of Cipla: long one call position with a premium of 25 rupees per stock at an exercise price of 400. At the same time, he is also willing to go for long one put option with a premium of 5 per stock at an exercise price of 300. The prevailing market price of Cipla stock is 350 rupees. The options are with the European one, which with an expiration date of 3 months. We are supposed to find out the profit and loss to the investor in the following market situation if in case the price of Cipla remains unchanged. Number one, if at expiration the price of Cipla rises to 500 rupees. And lastly, if at expiration the price of Cipla falls to 250. What should be done in these three scenarios? What is the real value that we'll be deriving with respect to the profit and losses to the investor? Number one thing that you need to keep in your mind is, guys, that he is entering into two positions simultaneously. Okay, that is not one by one. He is entering into both the positions simultaneously. At one point, he is buying one call option. That is, he wants to buy a buy option, okay, with a premium of 25 rupees per stock at an exercise price of 400. Exercise price, he has also already mentioned that 400 will be the exercise price, and for that particular stuff he has to pay option premium of 25 rupees per stock. And at the same time, he is also willing to buy a put option, which is he wants to buy a selling option, okay, with a premium of 5 rupees per stock at an exercise price of 300. Now the current price is 350. Now let's come directly to the understanding of this question part without entering into the solution phase. So if in case the expiration price for Cipla remains the same, which is 350, will he be going for a call option for 400? Do you think so? No, absolutely not. Why would he go and take up something for 400 when he can get the same thing in from the market directly at 350? Super. He won't be availing that option, okay? So what is the loss in this particular case is he will be losing out on an option premium of 25 rupees, which he paid right at the inception of the contract. Now, at the same time, he also underwent another contract, which is one long one put option. So will he be selling something for 300 when the market is providing him 350? Absolutely not. He will also not be selling something for 300 rupees because he can directly sell it into the market for 350. So again, he will be losing on to his option premium of 5 rupees. So if in case the market situation, at the expiration date, the price of Cipla remains the same level, so he will not be getting any kind of profit. He will only be getting losses, which is in respect of the option premium, that is 25 rupees for first one and second one for 5 rupees, which comes out to be 30 rupees. That is simple. Wonderful, guys. And now, as far as the second part is concerned, since the price of supply has risen to a position of 500, now, will he be going for availing of the call option? Absolutely, he will. He will be buying from you the call option because that is something which is making him obtain the security for 400 rupees. And at the same time, the security will be available in the market for 500. So definitely, he will go for it. He will make up a gain of 100 rupees. Now, he was also supposed to pay a premium of 25 rupees. So he will be gaining net 75 rupees in this position. Now, at the same time, he has also entered into a put option, which is of selling the security for 300. Will he be selling it for 300, wherein the market is providing him for 500 rupees? Absolutely not. He will surely not be selling it into the market, because the market will be providing him 500 rupees and this contract will provide him only 300 rupees. So he has to let go of this particular option, and he will be losing out on an opportunity of the option premium, which is rupees 5. So overall, if in case at expiration the price of Cipla rises to 500, he will be again surely getting a benefit of 100 rupees in the call, first call option. Deduct your premium, which is of first option, which is 25, and deduct your premium of second option, which is your 5 rupees. So he will still be able to manage getting a decent figure of 70 rupees in his pocket if in case the price of Cipla rises to 500. Sorted, guys. And lastly, if at expiration the price of Cipla falls to 250, now he has underwent a call option of 400 rupees. Okay, he wants to buy something for 400. Will he be going ahead and buying something for 400, wherein he can get the same from the market for 250? Absolutely not. He won't be going for it. So your first option gets rejected. Now you will be losing onto an opportunity of premium, that is 25 in first case. And at the same time, now he says that you also underwent another contract, which was a put option. So you're supposed to sell the security for 300 rupees. Okay, will you be selling it for 300, wherein the market is providing you 250? Absolutely yes, you will be going ahead and sell the particular security for 300, because you are getting a profit of 50 over here. So now 50 rupees profit minus 25 rupees premium that you paid for first option, minus 5 rupees premium that you paid for another option, next option. So still you managed a decently well amount of 20 rupees in your pocket. Okay, you were able to get your ends meet in this particular scenario, and certainly you were able to draw up a figure of 20 rupees in your pocket with respect to the third option. This was the question which has been like asked multiple number of times, which is very, very, very simple. Okay, this question has been asked in 2008, 10, 11, in fact 13 and 15 as well. So I've seen this question is one of the hotshot questions and one of the favorite questions amongst all the examination authority which makes our paper, which prepares our examination paper. So just go ahead with it, and it's a very simple one. So here is the solution for it, which I just made you understand. Long call is one which will be exercised only and only if in case the stock price increases above the strike price. Okay. And long put will be exercised only if in case the stock price decreases below the strike price. So what was the amount which I just quoted to you in the first scenario? That was 30. You will be making up a loss of 30 because you have paid him the option premium for 25 for first option, 5 rupees for another option. So that was the overall loss. In case the price touches the bar of 500, you will be able to make 70 rupees profit in this particular scenario. And lastly, if in case the Cipla stock price touches the bar of 250, you will still be able to manage a decently good amount, which is 20 rupees in that scenario as well. This was the last question of this particular presentation, and this was the last question of this particular topic of derivatives. I hope now you guys are super confident about the kind of stuff that will be asked in CA1L examination, and definitely you will just bang on once the examination question paper appears in front of you. So do not skip onto your revisions. Just revise whatever the kind of stuff that I'm teaching you up, and ensure that you give thorough time for your revisions and retain whatever the kind of things that you are revising. That is something which is extremely important. I'm sure and I'm hopeful about this thing that you must have liked this video. If in case you have found this video informative, if in case you have liked this video, and if in case you know that this video is going to be really useful for your friends, then do share it with as many people as you can. Thank you on behalf of the ADPDR world. Stay connected, guys. Till then, God bless you all. Sayonara. Take care. Bye.